Dear listeners, tonight I will take you on a journey to a tranquil village nestled among emerald hills, where an ancient Celtic legend of bravery and magic comes to life. The tale of Grogoch, the invisible guardian. Settle in comfortably, close your eyes, and let yourselves be enveloped by this enchanting story. Grogoch, the invisible guardian. Ancient Celtic legend. In the heart of a lush valley, cradled by rolling hills and emerald forests, lay the serene village of Ballycraig. The village, with its quaint cottages and cobblestone paths, had long been a place of peace and prosperity. The fields surrounding Ballycraig were once a tapestry of vibrant greens and golds, where crops grew in abundance and livestock roamed freely. The gentle hum of daily life was accompanied by the cheerful songs of birds and the soft rustling of leaves in the breeze. The villagers, known for their hard work and close-knit community, thrived on the land's bounty, living harmoniously with nature. But a shadow had crept over Ballycraig, casting a pall of fear and uncertainty. It began subtly, almost imperceptibly. The first sign was the failing crops. Stalks that once stood tall and proud now wilted and turned brown. Fields that had yielded bountiful harvests now lay barren and lifeless. The villagers tried to revive their plants, pouring their hearts into the soil, but their efforts were in vain. The land, it seemed, had turned against them. Soon after, the livestock began to disappear. Sheep, cows, and chickens vanished without a trace, leaving behind only empty pens and anxious owners. The village's source of sustenance was dwindling, and with it, the hope that had always been a hallmark of Ballycraig. The vibrant life that once filled the village square with laughter and chatter was replaced by hushed whispers and worried glances. Fear spread like a contagion, gripping the hearts of the villagers. The cause of these misfortunes was a subject of much speculation. Some believed it to be the work of a vengeful spirit. Others thought it a punishment from the gods. But as the days turned into weeks, and the weeks into months, a single name began to surface more frequently in the conversations of the worried villagers: Famorian. According to ancient legends, Famorian was a malevolent force that dwelled deep within the earth. It was said to awaken in times of strife, bringing calamity and despair to those it encountered. The tales spoke of its immense power and its ability to blight the land, destroy crops, and steal livestock. The very mention of Famorian sent shivers down the spines of those who uttered its name. Desperation began to set in. The villagers, once a beacon of resilience, found themselves at a loss. The village elders, who had seen many seasons come and go, could not recall a time of such hardship. The youngest children, sensing the unease of their parents, clung to them tightly, their innocent eyes wide with fear. The village needed a solution, and it needed one quickly. One crisp evening, under a sky streaked with the colors of dusk, the community gathered in the village square. The square, usually a place of lively markets and joyous celebrations, was now filled with somber faces. Torches flickered in the twilight, casting long shadows on the cobblestones. The villagers stood in a circle, their heads bowed, their voices low. They shared their worries, their fears, and their hopes for a brighter tomorrow. In the midst of the gathering, an old man stepped forward. His name was Kion, and he was known far and wide for his wisdom and knowledge of the old ways. His hair was as white as the first snowfall of winter, and his eyes, though dimmed by age, still held a spark of ancient fire. He raised his hands, and the murmurs of the crowd ceased. "Listen well, my friends," Kion began, his voice steady and strong. "The troubles we face are not of this world alone. They stem from forces beyond our understanding, from a darkness that has awakened from its slumber. Fomorian, the blight upon our land, is the source of our woes." A collective gasp rose from the villagers. They had feared as much, but to hear it confirmed by the wise Xian sent a chill through the crowd. "But all is not lost," Xian continued, his voice lifting with a note of hope. "Long ago, before even I was born, there were beings who walked among us, unseen, but ever present. The Grogoch, they were called, guardians of the natural world, protectors of the balance of life. It is said that they possess the power to heal the land and banish the darkness. If we can find a Grogoch, we may yet save Ballycraig." Hope flickered in the hearts of the villagers, like the torches that surrounded them. The tales of the Grogoch were ancient, passed down through generations, and many had dismissed them as mere legend. But in their hour of need, they clung to any glimmer of hope. As the meeting drew to a close, the villagers dispersed, each carrying with them a renewed sense of purpose. The task ahead was daunting, and the path uncertain, but the prospect of finding a Grogoch and restoring their village filled them with a resolve they had not felt in months. Ballycraig might have been shrouded in darkness, but within its people, a light of hope began to shine once more. With the weight of the village's hope resting heavily upon his shoulders, young farmer Aiden prepared for his journey. Aiden was known throughout Ballycraig for his unwavering courage and his kind heart. Tall and sturdy, with a mop of unruly brown hair and eyes that shone with determination, he embodied the spirit of the village. As he packed his modest belongings into a worn leather satchel, the villagers gathered to offer their support and well wishes. Each whispered word of encouragement and every gentle pat on the back reinforced his resolve. The morning of his departure was shrouded in a delicate mist, the sun struggling to pierce through the early haze. Aiden stood at the edge of the village, his gaze fixed on the path ahead. He knew the journey would be fraught with challenges, but the thought of his friends and family suffering spurred him on. With a final nod to the assembled crowd, he took his first steps into the unknown, the mist swallowing him almost immediately. Aiden's journey began in the dense woodlands that bordered Ballycraig. The forest was ancient, its towering trees standing as silent sentinels. Leaves rustled softly overhead, and the scent of damp earth and pine filled the air. guided only by the tales of old that the elders had shared. Aiden ventured deeper into the heart of the forest. He followed barely visible trails and navigated through thick underbrush, each step taking him further from the familiar. As the days turned into nights, Aiden pressed on, his determination unwavering. He traversed mist-covered valleys where the air was thick and cool, and the ground was carpeted with lush ferns and moss. These valleys, often shrouded in an ethereal fog, seemed to belong to another world entirely. The mist clung to him like a shroud, dampening his clothes and seeping into his bones. Yet, Aiden remained undeterred, his thoughts always on the village and the people he loved. The journey grew more treacherous as he climbed over steep, rocky hills. The paths were narrow and winding, the footing uncertain. Loose stones threatened to send him tumbling down the slopes, but Aiden's resolve was steadfast. He scaled craggy outcrops and navigated precarious ledges, the rugged terrain testing his endurance. Each night, he found shelter where he could. A hollow beneath an ancient oak, a small cave hidden from the elements. He would light a small fire, its flickering flames providing warmth and a sense of companionship in the solitude of the wilderness. Days blended into each other, the passage of time marked only by the changing light and the phases of the moon. Aiden's journey was long and arduous, his body growing weary with each passing day. There were moments when despair threatened to take hold, but the thought of the village, now suffering under Fomorian's curse, pushed him onward. He recalled the wise words of Kion, the old man who had first spoken of the Grogoch, and the glimmer of hope that had ignited in the hearts of the villagers. Aiden was standing on the edge of a lonely glade one evening, as the sun was setting, and the sky was aflame with pink and orange hues. The soft buzz of nature and the aroma of wildflowers filled the air. A moss-covered grotto was in the middle of the glade, partially concealed by spreading ivy and rich foliage. Ancient stones encircled the entrance, their surfaces weathered with patterns that appeared to recall a long-forgotten tale. Aiden's heart quickened with a mixture of anticipation and trepidation. This had to be the place the elders spoke of, the hidden sanctuary of the Grogoch. Gathering his courage, he approached the cave with reverence. He stood at its entrance, the weight of his quest bearing down upon him. With a deep breath, he called out into the darkness. "Grogoch," he began, his voice steady but filled with earnestness. "I am Aiden, a farmer from Ballycraig. Our village is in grave danger. Fomorian, the malevolent force, has brought ruin upon our land. Our crops have withered, our livestock has vanished, and our hope is dwindling. Please, I beg of you, help us in our time of need." His words echoed softly within the cave, swallowed by the silence that followed. Aiden waited, his heart pounding in his chest. The forest around him seemed to hold its breath, the usual sounds of nature falling eerily silent. Moments stretched into what felt like an eternity, the uncertainty weighing heavily on him. He wondered if the Grogoch would hear his plea, or if the tales of its existence were merely legend. just as doubt began to creep into his mind. A gentle breeze stirred the air, carrying with it a faint whisper. From the depths of the moss-covered cave emerged a figure shrouded in ancient mystery and wisdom, the Grogoch. This legendary being, seldom seen by mortal eyes, carried with it an aura of timeless knowledge and an air of serene power. Its form was neither fully human nor entirely spirit, but a blend of both, with features that seemed to shift like shadows in the twilight. The Grogoch's eyes, deep and knowing, sparkled with an inner light that spoke of ages past and secrets untold. As Aiden watched in awe, the Grogoch stepped forward, its presence filling the small clearing with a palpable sense of calm and authority. Moved by Aiden's heartfelt plea and sensing the courage and sincerity that radiated from the young farmer, the Grogoch nodded slowly. It understood the gravity of the situation and the desperation that had driven Aiden to seek it out. The connection between them was immediate and profound, forged in the crucible of necessity and shared purpose. "I will help you, young Aiden." The Grogoch's voice was like a whisper carried on the wind, gentle yet firm. "Your heart is pure, and your cause is just. Together, we shall restore balance to Ballycraig." With the Grogoch's agreement, a newfound sense of hope blossomed in Aiden's chest. The journey back to Ballycraig was swift, the Grogoch moving through the forest with a grace and ease that belied its otherworldly nature. Aiden followed, his steps lighter and his spirits higher than they had been in weeks. The forest, once foreboding and oppressive, now seemed alive with possibility, the leaves rustling with the promise of renewal. As they approached Ballycraig, the first rays of dawn broke the horizon, casting a golden glow over the settlement. They arrived to a picture of quiet desolation. The once luxurious fields had turned bare, and there was a general sense of melancholy in the air. But now that the Grogoch was on his side, Aiden felt a renewed sense of resolve. They were going to remove the darkness that had crept into this place. The Grogoch wasted no time. It moved through the village with a purposeful stride, its mere presence bringing a sense of peace and reassurance to the anxious villagers. Wherever the Grogoch went, the land seemed to respond. Fields that had been withered and dry began to show signs of life. Shoots of green sprouted from the soil, and the earth itself seemed to sigh in relief. The Grogoch knelt beside a particularly barren patch of land, its hands hovering over the ground. A soft, luminescent glow emanated from its fingertips, sinking into the soil and spreading like a wave. Within moments, the once desolate field was teeming with vibrant growth, the crops springing to life with renewed vigor. The villagers watched in awe and reverence, their hearts lifting with every miracle they witnessed. Livestock that had disappeared began to return, emerging from the forest with a calm assurance, as if drawn by an invisible force. The air was filled with the sounds of life once more, the lowing of cattle, the clucking of hens, and the gentle rustle of leaves in the breeze. Ballycraig, it seemed, was awakening from a long and terrible nightmare. But amidst the joy and relief, Aiden knew that the true test still lay ahead. The Grogoch, too, understood that while the immediate damage could be repaired, the root cause of their suffering, Fomorian, remained unchallenged. They could not rest until the malevolent spirit was confronted and banished. The Grogoch turned to Aiden, its expression grave but resolute. "We have mended what we can for now," it said softly. "But to ensure the safety and prosperity of Ballycraig, we must face Fomorian. Preparations must be made for the confrontation that lies ahead." Aiden nodded, his resolve hardening like steel. With the Grogoch's guidance, he and the villagers began to prepare for the ultimate battle. They fortified the village, setting wards and protective charms around the perimeter. They gathered supplies and crafted weapons imbued with the Grogoch's natural magic. Each villager played a part, their collective efforts a testament to their unity and determination. Aiden trained tirelessly, honing his skills and learning from the Grogoch. The guardian taught him the ancient ways, revealing secrets of the natural world and the delicate balance that must be maintained. Under the Grogoch's tutelage, Aiden grew not only in strength, but in wisdom, understanding that the battle ahead was not just of physical prowess, but of wit and spirit. The night before the anticipated confrontation, the village gathered once more in the square. This time, their faces were not marred by fear, but illuminated by hope and resolve. They looked to Aiden and the Grogoch with trust, believing in the strength and wisdom that had been imparted to them. "Tomorrow, we face our greatest challenge," Aiden spoke, his voice clear and steady. "But we do not face it alone. We have the Grogoch, the guardian of our land, and we have each other. Together, we will reclaim our home and our future." As the villagers dispersed to rest and ready themselves for the dawn, Aiden stood with the Grogoch, gazing out over the village. The night was still and quiet, the stars twinkling like distant promises. Aiden felt a deep sense of calm wash over him, bolstered by the presence of the ancient guardian by his side. "We will succeed," the Grogoch said softly, its eyes reflecting the starlight. "For the heart of Ballycraig beats strong and true, and no darkness can withstand the light of such unity and courage." Aiden nodded, his heart filled with hope and determination. The path ahead was clear, and with the Grogoch's guidance, he felt ready to face whatever challenges awaited them. Together, they would confront the darkness, restore the balance, and ensure that the light of Ballycraig would shine brightly once more. The storm rolled in with a ferocity that mirrored the tension brewing in Ballycraig. Dark clouds gathered ominously overhead, and the wind howled through the village, rattling shutters and whipping through the trees. Lightning split the sky, illuminating the fearful faces of the villagers huddled together in their homes, peering anxiously through windows and doors. They knew the moment had come. Fomorian was here. From the depths of the shadows, the malevolent spirit rose, its form twisted and grotesque, a terrifying embodiment of chaos and despair. Fomorian's presence seemed to suck the very light from the air, casting an unnatural darkness over Ballycraig. The ground trembled beneath its weight, and a cold, eerie silence fell over the village, broken only by the distant rumble of thunder. In the heart of the village, Aiden and the Grogoch stood ready. Aiden's heart pounded in his chest, but he remained resolute, bolstered by the Grogoch's calming presence. The guardian's ethereal form glowed softly, a beacon of hope amidst the encroaching darkness. They exchanged a determined glance, a silent affirmation of their shared purpose. Fomorian surged forward, its monstrous form towering over the village. The villagers watched in fear, their hopes pinned on the brave duo who stood between them and the malevolent force. Aiden gripped his weapon tightly, feeling the weight of his responsibility, but also the strength of his resolve. This was the moment they had prepared for, the culmination of their efforts and the test of their courage. As Fomorian approached, Aiden and the Grogoch sprang into action. Aiden moved with agility and precision, using his knowledge of the land and his quick wits to outmaneuver the spirit. He darted between buildings, luring Fomorian into a carefully laid trap. The Grogoch, drawing upon the ancient powers of the earth, began to weave potent spells, the air crackling with magical energy. Fomorian, sensing the threat, lashed out with a fury that shook the very foundations of the village. Dark tendrils of shadow extended from its form, seeking to ensnare Aiden and the Grogoch. But Aiden, quick and nimble, evaded the attacks, guiding Fomorian closer to the trap they had set. The Grogoch's spells shimmered in the air, forming an intricate web of light and energy designed to bind the spirit. With a final, desperate lunge, Fomorian charged at Aiden, its monstrous form looming over him. In that critical moment, Aiden sprang the trap. He activated the hidden wards and talismans placed strategically around the village square. A brilliant light erupted from the ground, encircling Fomorian and halting its advance. The spirit roared in fury, thrashing against the bindings that now held it in place. The Grogoch stepped forward, its eyes blazing with ancient power. Chanting in a language as old as the earth itself, it unleashed a torrent of magical energy. The air hummed with the force of the incantation, the very fabric of reality bending to the Grogoch's will. Fomorian writhed in agony, the power of the spells weakening its hold on the physical world. Aiden knew this was the pivotal moment. With a shout of determination, he charged at Fomorian, his weapon glowing with the Grogoch's enchantments. He struck with all his might, the blade cutting through the shadowy form of the spirit. Fomorian let out a deafening wail, its essence unraveling under the combined assault of Aiden's strength and the Grogoch's magic. The battle reached its climax in a dazzling display of light and shadow. Aiden and the Grogoch fought with a synchronized precision, their movements a harmonious dance of might and magic. Each strike, each spell, brought them closer to their goal. The villagers watched in awe and trepidation, their hearts pounding as they witnessed the epic clash unfold. Finally, with a resounding incantation that echoed through the stormy night, the Grogoch completed the binding spell. the ground beneath Fomorian opened up, a swirling vortex of light and energy, drawing the spirit back into the depths of the earth. Aiden delivered a final, decisive blow, severing the last tether that held Fomorian to the mortal realm. With a roar that shook the heavens, Fomorian was sealed back into the earth's depths. The vortex closed with a thunderous clap, and a profound silence fell over Ballycraig. The storm began to abate, the clouds parting to reveal a sky studded with stars. The air was clear and fresh, the oppressive darkness lifted. Exhausted but triumphant, Aiden and the Grogoch stood together in the village square. The villagers, their fear replaced by awe and gratitude, emerged from their homes, cheering and weeping with relief. The curse that had plagued Ballycraig was broken. The fields would flourish once more, and life would return to the village. Aiden, breathing heavily, looked to the Grogoch, who gave a nod of satisfaction. They had faced the darkness together and emerged victorious. The bond forged in the crucible of battle would not be easily broken, and the lessons learned would be remembered for generations. As dawn broke, casting a golden light over Ballycraig, the village celebrated its heroes. Aiden and the Grogoch were hailed as saviors, their bravery and sacrifice ensuring the safety and prosperity of their home. The storm had passed, and with it, a new day dawned for Ballycraig, a day filled with hope and promise. The Grogoch, though rarely seen, continued to watch over Ballycraig, ensuring that the lessons of respect and harmony endured forever. And so, my dear listeners, that was Grogoch, the Invisible Guardian. Aiden's courage and the Grogoch's magic brought hope and renewal to Ballycraig, saving the village from the clutches of the malevolent Fomorian. Their bravery and wisdom became a beacon of light in the darkest of times. Remember, behind every shadow lies a story waiting to be uncovered, and within every heart, a hero ready to emerge. If you enjoyed tonight's tale from the heart of ancient Celtic, please give it a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss another mystical story. What would you do if you were in Aiden's shoes? Would you venture into the unknown to save your village? Let us know in the comments below. Until next time, may you have sweet dreams and magical adventures every night.